Your place, Alappuzha, the smallest district of the God's own country, Kerala, in India, the incidence of end-stage kidney disease on the rise.
Actually, what we see in Kerala today is just like a fast food culture. They have a lot of food with increased amount of salt, spices, fried chickens, etc. will be there. And there are also a lot of soft drinks.
Renal disorders usually are symptomatic during the initial stages. But once it is progresses, patient may present with edema, especially the facial puffiness, the edema around the eyes and pedal edema. And later, once it is advances, there is the symptoms like uremic gastritis, there is persistent vomiting, nausea, loss of appetite, loss of weight. Also, a patient has the features of volume overload, that is, there is severe fluid overload. So patient will present with dyspnea, orthopnea, and inability to sleep at night. And most often these patients have severe anemia as a part of end-stage renal disease. And also these patients have the features of this renal osteodystrophy, severe bone pain, and reduced calcium, that is hypocalcemia.
Our institution probably is the only tertiary care center in the district. So very often we do tunnel dialysis catheterization as vascular access for performing hemodialysis. In the last 6 months, we had done around 55 tunnel dialysis catheterization, and most of these patients continue their maintenance hemodialysis in their hometown. Of late, we notice an increased incidence of catheter-related issues like malfunction, infection, or catheter dislodgement. So this could be due to factors either patient-related or center-related. Of the various complications, the most common probably is infection, which often manifests as discharge, redness, swelling, and sometimes fever, chills, fatigue, hypotension, altered ventilation, and not uncommonly metastatic infections. In our hometown, majority are not aware of the importance of catheter care, which is in fact their lifeline.
Catheter-related infections are the second most common cause of mortality in the dialysis population. Hence, catheter care is of utmost importance. Strict adherence to personal hygiene is pertinent. Steps of hand hygiene as per WHO guidelines should be meticulously practiced. Patient's body extending from neck down to umbilical, both anteriorly and posteriorly, including axilla, should be painted. Bathing with head shower 2 to 3 times a day is a common practice prevailing in this part of state. While bathing, care should be taken to avoid catheter dressings getting wet. Patient lies down on a bench, head is lowered a bit, and the caregiver gives a head bath carefully.
Hello. The most important objective for a patient having cannula for the purpose of dialysis is to observe that the cannula does not get infected. Increased urea content in the saliva can in turn alter the bacterial ecology and lead to periodontitis. The bacterial load can induce bacteremia in the body. Through this bacteremia, the cannula which is placed can also get infected. Home care, the patient can himself take care of his own teeth and gums by appropriately brushing the teeth using toothbrush and paste, by massaging the gums, by cleaning the tongue, and also with the help of interdental aids like dental floss and interdental brush to clean effectively in between the teeth. So it is very important that these patients maintain meticulous oral hygiene. Stringent care is taken by these patients to avoid salivary contamination on the cannula. So wishing you a speedy recovery. Have a good day.
We decided to spread awareness and training for patients and their caregivers to improve the catheter care through educational films. And we are glad that we made several awareness films, documentaries, and educational campaigns under the auspices of the Department of Nephrology, Government TD Medical College, Alappuzha. At this juncture, I would like to illustrate the real-life situation of a patient with K catheter-related bacterial sepsis. One of our patients who was undergoing maintenance hemodialysis via tunnel dialysis catheter developed endophthalmitis a few months after catheterization. She belonged to a very low socioeconomic class and was homeless, struggling to make a living. Though catheter was handled with utmost care in the dialysis center, she developed a very serious life-threatening endophthalmitis, which was treated rigorously and she regained vision partially. She was educated subsequently intensively regarding catheter care and personal hygiene with special emphasis on hand hygiene. Now she is continuing maintenance hemodialysis without much problem. She is a real fighter and she continues to fight against her unhygienic surroundings for survival. Now she has succeeded in controlling sepsis and is now leading a very happy normal life and spreading awareness and inspiration to the rest of the society, especially to CKD patients. As a nephrology community, it's our responsibility to prevent infection in our patients and improve their quality of life. For the same, we all shall move forward together.
I'm Regina, my husband is Yavshad. I'm a dialysis patient. I'm a dialysis patient. ഞങ്ങൾ ഹാപ്പിയാണ്. എനിക്ക് രണ്ട് കുട്ടികളുണ്ട്, ഒരു കുഴപ്പമില്ല. ഞങ്ങളിപ്പോൾ സന്തുഷ്ടവതിയാണ് ഇപ്പം. ഇതും പിന്നെ ഡോക്ടർ തന്ന ട്രീറ്റ്മെൻറ്റും അവർ പറഞ്ഞിരുന്ന ഇതിൽ ശ്രദ്ധയായിട്ട് പോയ അവരെ സ്നേഹം കൂടെ കിട്ടിയ നമ്മളൊരു രോഗമില്ല നമുക്ക്. നല്ല ഒരു പേഷ്യൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് തന്നെയാണ് മുന്നോട്ട് പോകുന്നത്. ഒരു കുഴപ്പമില്ല എനിക്ക്, ഞാൻ എല്ലാ ജോലിയും ചെയ്യും.